Hi students, dear students, today we discuss one more chapter of the 4th standard, that is time chapter. Dear students, you already learned in your previous classes, there are 7 days in one week. What are they? They are Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday and Saturday. There are 7 days in one week. Dear student, 30 are 31 days present in month. Dear student, you already learned 30 are 31 days present in one month. But February has only 28 or 29 days. Dear student, remaining months having 30 or 31 days, but only February has 28 or 29 days. Dear student, there are 12 months present in one year. What are they? They are January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November and December. There are 12 months present in one year. Dear student, how many days in one year? Dear student, the one year has 365 days. Dear student, how many days in one year? There are 365 days in one year. Dear student, accurately, the one year having 365 days, 6 hours. Accurately, one year having 365 days, 6 hours. It means 365, 1 by 4 days. Accurately, one year has 365, 1 by 4 days. Dear student, 1 by 4. So we consider only the 365 days present in one year. The remaining 1 by 4 is completely added. The 4 times it will becomes 1 day. Okay. Dear student, 1 by 4 is remaining. We consider only the 1 year having 365 days. The remaining 1 by 4 is added 4 times, you will get 1 day. Therefore, dear student, every 4 years we can add this 1 day. Dear student, every 4 years once we can add 1 day, because the remaining 1 by 4 is added 4 times for 4 years. Okay. So it will get 1 day is increased from 365. Therefore, the 1 day is added to every after 4 years. So the number of days present in the every 4 years are 366 days. This year we call it as a leap year. Okay, dear student, every 4 years once we can add 1 day. Okay, so the number of days present in that year, 366, that year we called it as a leap year. In a leap year having 366 days. Okay, so this year we called it as a leap year. Dear student, the one more clue for identification of the leap year, that is the February. We can add one day to the February, that year is increase the one day of every years, that is 366. Dear student, the February month having 29 days. Every 4 years once, the February has 29 days. Therefore, the February has 29 days. That year we call it as a leap year, because the one day is added every 4 years once. So, the February has 29 days. Dear students, the every 4 years once, we can add one day to that year. Therefore, the February has 29 days every 4 years once. Therefore, that year 360 days present, 66 days present in that year, we call it as a leap year. Dear students, the leap year comes every 4 months, 4 years once. Okay. So, dear student, how to identify the leap year? I give one of the calculations to finding the leap year. Dear student, show with an example. Example 1. Dear student, I give one number, one of the year, 1904. Okay, 1904, this is the year. You find out this year is leap year or not. How to find this year is, the given year is leap year or not? Dear student, you observe the last 2 digit of this year. The 2 digit of the year, last 2 digit of the year is completely divided by 4. So, it is completely divided, that year we call it as a leap year. The last 2 digit is not completely divided by 4, that year is not a leap year. Dear student, the given year, the last 2 digit are 04. The 04 is completely divided by 4. Yes. Dear student, the 4 is completely divided by 4. 4 ones are 4. It is completely divided. The remainder is 0. So, the 4 is completely divided by 4. That, therefore, the 1904 year is leap year. Okay. So, I give one more example to identification of a leap year. Example 2, 1824 is there. You observe last 2 digits. The 2 digits are completely divided by 4. You can check it. 24 divided by 4. 4, 6 are 24. So, this is completely divided. Okay. So, 1824 is the leap year. Therefore, 1824 is leap year. Because the last 2 digit of the year is completely divided by 4. Therefore, the 1824 year is a leap year. This is the method to identification of a leap year. I take one more example to find out this year is leap year or not. Okay. Example 3. 1714. This is leap year or not? You consider last 2 digit, the 14 is divided by 4. Okay. So, you divide by 4. 4, 14. So, 4, 3 is 12. 4 minus 2, 2, 1 minus 1, 0. Dear student, the 14 is not completely divided, because the remainder is 2. Therefore, this year is not a leap year. Dear student, 1714 is not leap year. Because the 14 is not completely divided by 4. Okay. Therefore, this year is not a leap year. This is the method to finding the leap year. are noun. Okay. Next, go to the reading and calculation of the time. Dear student, reading and calculation of time. Dear student, you already learned the reading of time for your previous class. Today I give small informations are to recall the reading of time by using a clock. Dear student, first we reading the time by using the clock or wristwatch or any other digital gadgets we can use to reading the time. Dear students, in nowadays so many electronic gadgets are here to reading the time. In olden days we can use the moment of the sun to identification or to reading the time. In the olden days, the old people, we can use the moment of the sun to understanding the time. Dear student, nowadays so many gadgets are present to reading the time. First we taken, that is clock. Clock is the best instrument to read and note of the times. Okay, first I draw one of the clock, then we discuss how to read the time. Okay, dear student, I draw the three clocks. Dear student, you already learned the clock have two hands, long hand and short hand. The long hand represent the minutes and the short hand represents the hour, and the clock having a numbers from 1 to 12. This is the 12-hour clock. Dear student, this is a 12-hour clock because the clock having a numbers from 1 to 12. So this is a 12-hour clock. Dear student, 24-hour clock is also there. So you discuss 24-hour clock for the next class. Dear student, so this is the 12-hour clock. The three clocks having a different time measurement. Dear student, the first clock, what is the time in the first class? First clock, what is the time of the first clock? Dear student, the short hand is at 2 and the minute hand, long hand, is at 12. So what is the time in this clock? 2 o'clock. Dear student, it is a 2 o'clock. Come to the second clock. Dear student, the short hand is at 6 and long hand is at 3. How to read the time? What's the time in this clock? Dear student, the time is, we can read at 6. Okay, 6. In the third, the short hand is at 1 and the long hand is at 9. It is 2:15. 2:15. 2:15. Dear student, you already know in your previous class how to read the time by knowing the minute and hour hand position. Dear student, in the first class, the hour hand is at 2 and the minute hand is at 12. So, it is exactly 2 o'clock. Dear student, in the second clock, the minute hand is in 3 and the hour hand is at 6. Dear student, you already know the minute hand is at 3. It is in quarter. So, it is slightly passed to the quarter. That's why we call it as a quarter past 6. So, the minute hand is at 9 and hour is at 1. Dear student, it is already the hour hand is passed to the 1. It is nearer to the 2 o'clock. That's why we called it as a quarter to 2. Dear student, it is nearer to the 2 o'clock. That's why we called it as a quarter to 2. This is the time reading by using the clock for the different positions of the needles or hands or the position of the hour hand and minute hand. Okay. In this class, again, I change the reading of the position of the needles. You can say what's the time. Dear student, hour hand is at 5 and minute hand is at 3. It is at quarter past 5. Quarter past 5. This is quarter past 8. Quarter past 8. And this one, quarter past 11. Quarter past 11. It is quarter past 12. Quarter past 12. Okay. Then come to the this is the minute hand. This is hour hand. Dear student, what's the time now? Dear student, the minute hand is at 9 and hour hand is at 1. So we read the time quarter to 2. You mention the minute hand is at 9 and hour hand is at any number, we can say the quarter to the next number. Quarter to next number. Okay. So the time is quarter to 2 because the position of the hour hand is noted 1, but we read it as a quarter to 2. We call it as a quarter to next number or next digit. Okay. Quarter to 2. This is quarter to 5. This is quarter to 8. This is quarter to 12. Okay. Then come to the next clock. Both minute hand and hour hand in the 12 number. So this is at 12 o'clock. The minute hand also in the 12 and hour hand is also at 12. The time is 12 o'clock. Okay. So this is the reading of the time. I show the one more reading of the time. That is, dear student, minute hand is at 6 and hour hand is at 1. Dear student, we call how to read this one. The minute hand is at 6 and the hour hand is at 1. So it is a half past 1. Half past 1. The minute hand is exactly in 6 and hour hand is any number, we call it as a half past for that number. This is half past 1. Change the position. Half past 3. Half past 5. Half past 8. Half past 12. Okay. So, come to the next reading of the time. Dear students,